Pazanos, it's the Super Mario Brothers Super Show.
Hey's everybody doing today? We have a special double feature. I will be unboxing a minifigure
Princess Peach.
And then I also have a special treat. I have the big, the bad, the Koopa, my Koopa Poopa. Yes, I kind of got tired of waiting for them to release the King Koopa minifigure that would be, I guess, more in scale with the previous ones that they've released so far. And, I mean, I guess at this point, this company called Banpresto has the rights for them. Before, it was some other company. I can't remember the name, and I didn't bother to look it up. So first, I'm going to open Princess Peach. Although I still call her Princess Toadstool. And for this one, I usually have my trusty X-Acto knife, but...
Sick it.
So, just... open up, tear off the card. Oh my god, he ripped it. And there's the booble. And here's Princess Peach. She's flying. And she's just gonna pop right out here. Pretty, you know, solid. I mean, I don't really know what more detail you need to get for Princess Peach. You know, she has her crown. She has, let's see if we can zoom in on that. Sorry about the noise. Yeah, so, I mean, she has her crown, the dress, the hem, I don't know, all that stuff. So she kind of looks pretty. Yeah, zoom, zoom, zoom. So, you know, for, I don't know, what, $3, $4, or $5 or whatever. You know, I've been waiting to pick her up probably, I don't know, months. And I originally saw her at a comic store, and she was, like, I don't know, $8, $9, $10 or something like that. So, cool, we have... Peach, and we have Mario, and she fits in nicely, and...
Oh, Luigi, you fall down. Oh, Luigi is trying to pat the Peach on the ass.
So we have those guys, and the thing, I guess the reason why I wanted to get the big Koopa was for the purposes of scale. And to open up this guy, just gonna take out this, cut me some tape... open up the top of the box here. Now, I don't even know what these are. Okay, cool. There's a kind of a hard shell here. I mean, so that's kind of cool for display purposes, I guess. And he comes packed in a nice bubble shell here. And yeah, this dude's plastic. I mean, this is kind of neat, actually. And if you probably wanted to put other people in there, you could. That's really cool, actually. You know, if you wanted to display Mario and Peach, say, for instance, and you could do that. That's kind of an added bonus to that. That's really cool. So, okay, but here's Koopa. Neat. Oh, man, I gotta love that new toy smell. I mean, it's probably as good as Koopa can get. I mean, nice detail on the spine shells here. You know, he's got his S&M gear on, his arm, shoulder, wrist pads. He looks cool. He's a little soft, like his stomach is a little squishy. You can kind of bend his mouth. But overall, pretty neat. His tail's a little bendy. So not, I mean, I guess I thought he was going to be some sort of like, I don't know, for whatever reason, I thought porcelain or something like that. So he is a little flexible, so kind of a soft plastic, but... nonetheless, pretty cool. You know, he's got his horns here and his spiky things, and they're kind of sharp. I mean, for plastic. So I'm kind of glad I went with this guy, and everything kind of just fell. You know, in terms of scale, I like that. I you know, really was afraid that I would wait and he would be too small. And honestly, that is almost perfect size for me. So this is a... I don't think I could have asked for a better purchase here. You know, I'll throw in Princess Toadstool.
Hi, Mario.
So this is really cool. I'm glad to finally have Bowser, King Koopa, whatever you want to call him. And yeah, that's neat. And this shell thing is kind of cool for display purposes. You know, that is, like I said, that definitely adds value. It has his name on it. So, neat. I am glad I picked this up. It was like Toys R Us. It was like, I think, $12. And I'm certainly...